Okay, welcome, good morning to Calculus in the AM. I'm your host, Mr. Sadaka, Calculus 30, regular course. Looking at a few more substitution examples, just to make sure we're on the right track. Now, when I look at the first example, top left, what seems to be the best choice for your U value? Remember, often you could find it as the inside part, the inside function, composition. The other thing you have to take a look at, though, is whatever you choose for U will generally be of a higher degree if it's a polynomial portion. So that when you do du, you're going to get something with 1 degree lower. Okay? So that's sort of what you're also looking at. Let's take a look at this top left one here. What's the best choice for you for that one? Under the root sign. And that's, it is composition, it's inside. Also though, I see a quick scan, I see t squared. As soon as I do t squared, du, I know I'm gonna get that single t out of there and I need to eliminate that somehow. So that's two reasons why that's my choice. So we're gonna say let u equal t squared minus 4t. Then du equals 2t minus 4. Soon I have that dt. Excuse me, I'm going to cough. As soon as I have that, I think, I need brackets. I think also that I want to eliminate t minus 2 from the original expression. Can I get a t minus 2 out of there? Heck yeah. I'm going to factor out the number 2. So when I factor out the number 2, I'm going to just pull it out as a half on the other side. Well, I'll show it in two steps. T minus 2. Right, it is. Can be blamed for every mistake. Okay, so 1/2 du. To substitute, I've got all the ingredients, right, to replace. Now, 1/2 du represents t minus 2 and dt, right? The letter u represents something under the root sign. So I'm going to have u to the 1/2, and that's it, du. Half t. Blah, blah. I'll just get busy doing this. I'm going to put the 1/2 and 1/2 du out in front. I put u instead of the root sign, I put power of half, du. That's complete. You guys can do this integral in a jiffy. But instead of in a jiffy, I'd like you to do it in your notebook. Pardon me, we got the half sitting up in front. We got the I'm thinking the u, add 1, it's 3/2. So I put the reciprocal in front, 2/3. Let's see. And of course, we come up with 1/3. Oh, 1/3. Instead of u, I'm going to put in t squared minus 4t. Now it's a choice, you keep it as 3/2, you can put it as square root, and then cube it. If you wish the old school symbols, whatever, okay. Are we good with this? I didn't make any mistakes, I did good. Now let's try this next one here. What's the obvious choice for you? What's the inner function? You've already done this one, haven't you? X to the 4. And this one works out sweetly. So, let u equal x to the 4, du. You guys work this out. I'll stop in a second here. And we'll catch up. Tra-la-la. Did you guys get that? It's not as complicated as it looks. I think it is. Because once you've got e to the u, it's And I double check. If I do this derivative, the c's gone. E to the x to the 4 is repeated, but then the derivative of the inside. 4x cubed times 1 quarter, hey, it works. Tricky, maybe. This sine to the 5x, cosine of x, is the function I'm trying to work backwards on. What should I choose as my new value? The nice things about sines and cosines is when you choose one, du becomes the other, other than negative sine sometimes involved. Which is the more inner function? The sine. Because this means, remember, this means sine, right?
Yes.
So choose that as your u. Go for it.
Why don't you choose the other one as your u? Is it bad? Like, you take
it's not bad if you choose cosine, it's just wrong. But if you do it, think of this. You choose cosine, u equals cosine. Okay, you'll have a u here. But then your du will be just plain old sine. 1 to the power of 1. You'll still have 4 sine to the power of 4 left behind. Do you follow me on that?
Yeah.
And it won't eliminate. You won't get anywhere.
Yeah.
So you've got to choose u equals sine, and then you'll have u to the 5.
Okay.
The du will be cosine. It'll work. Go for it. Now, when I did that, right? Is that what people are getting, Mac? Okay. Yeah, you just. Is this along the right lines, though, for people? They got a good start on this? Or? So, when you got trig functions, choose the one with the power involved in it. It is the inner function. Remember, that's sort of your first hunch, if there is an inside function for composition. Choose that one. Sines and cosines become each other, but if you make the opposite choice, if you hit a dead end, try the other way. Now this last one, it's a complicated function. I would not be able to graph this off the top of my head or anything like that. Sine of, inside that, the natural log function x, all over x. Well, tell me, what is my best choice for you? What's your hunch?
Natural log of x.
Natural log of x, okay. This looks more complicated than it is. Like, to do. It's a complicated function. Work with me, guys. U equals the natural log of x, okay. Then, let. Then. And I give a mark for showing, doing the statement, the let statement, then du equals. So make sure you do that, if it's good stuff. What's the derivative there? That's one you gotta know.
E to the x. 1 over x.
So, right? 1 over x dx. Can you guys substitute that in there? Tell me what you get. I'll wait. Now here's what I'm saying here. I'll just do it here. It's tricky. So, I think this one's easy to see. U replaces this. I can think of this, and I'll just say think of this. I wouldn't recommend rewriting it as, but I'm going to just for this purpose. Sine of natural log of x, in case you have trouble seeing it. Now, I wouldn't really rewrite this, but you guys see how over x here really means 1 over x times whatever's on the top, right? So this means this is an exact match. DU is all of that. The letter U is just the inside of the sine function, right? So what I've got is, when you do the substituting as the sine function, the U is the inside of that, the natural log of x. The 1 over x dx portion is exactly equal to du. Once you do that, you say, what was it that I was, you're thinking backwards of differentiation. And it is, how'd you get a positive sign as an answer to a derivative? Negative cos. This is equal to negative cosine of u plus some constant. If you want, for variety, you could say minus some constant. It doesn't matter. We don't know. Anyways, then I just substitute in again for the value of u, natural log of